Hello and welcome to another stream. My name is Ray and it is Learning Korean Day 246. Yeah, thanks a lot for tuning in. Yesterday we continued with the Unit 1 test. We finished comprehension, the comprehension section. We started with the grammar section. There are like two questions left or so in the grammar section, and then the last section, the listening section, that is missing as well, and that will be the hardest part, and that's what we will do today. Apart from that, I thought maybe today, if the Unit 1 test finishes early, we could speak about the things that we do in the next few weeks. So the new content here on the in the learning project. However, I don't think we will actually finish the Unit 1 test very early. So if there are only like 5 minutes left in the end, I don't want to go over the topics. I want to have some time. And today I have to stop at 7 p.m. So we will finish the Unit 1 test, and I will show you something. So I have my problems with those particles from 2 and so on. So I said I need a chart, and I did the chart. So here's the chart for those particles. I definitely need to look a few times at this chart, at this table, and then I maybe can memorize it a bit better. So just go through it very quickly. So here we have from SO, which is for locations, not for time, cannot be used for time. And then we have Pourtant, which is from for time, can also be used for location, but it's a bit uncommon, a bit uncommon. So you would definitely use SO if you want to say from for locations. And then we have catchy for, or gachi for both of those, for location and time, meaning two, so that the target of the traveling or of the time interval, I don't know. it means two. So then ERO, that's is one that I didn't have a lot of problems with. I definitely memorized this one, so not really that important. Then we have AND. This was also fine for me. Here the difference is one is used for more for writing, one is used more for speech, or Hago is just used for both. There are definitely a little few things like notes missing in this chart, because for example this one, qua and wa, uses the reverse logic to decide which one you put after a syllable depending on the vowel or consonant in the end. If you have the consonant in the end, you use qua. You use also the one with the consonant, and if you have the vowel in the end, you use the one with the vowel. With all other particles, this is the other way around. It's just with this one. So here, for example, you use the one with the consonant, rang. You use it for words that end in a vowel, and you use the one with the vowel, so the e here, for words ending in a consonant. So that follows the normal pattern, only this one is different. Okay, and now this part. So this one is also to and from, like the ones at the top here. But these are for, maybe I should write for giving, for example. Giving, etc. Receiving, etc. So stuff like that. If you're giving something to somebody, you would use ege or hante or ge. And if you're receiving something from somebody, you will use the same with saw in the end. Or if you have a non-person, so for example, if you're receiving something from the government or from a company, you would use Euro Bouton. And then we have the for the benefit of. So I'm cooking for my brother. I'm doing the cooking for the benefit of somebody. Or purpose of verb. That was something that I could not remember before. So this one, it was described in the lesson as I do something to watch. I go to the cinema to watch the movie. We definitely had this specific type of sentence before. Yeah, I don't really remember in what other lesson or so, but here this one can be used as well for that case. Okay, and then we have Edehe for about. So, that's the chart. And I hope it will help me a bit. And I think it will. I think it will. So, these ones, they are very similar with the AG. Egeso, Hante, Hanteso, they are very similar and they also are on both sides of the giving and receiving action. So they also fit together. Okay, yeah, that's it. That's it for my chart. So I hope I can use this to my advantage. And with that being said, we will go to the Unit 1 test again. And we'll continue here. So the last thing we did, I will enable my little... No, I have to check my notepad. Where's my notepad? Here. 18B. Yeah, okay, so this was the last one we did yesterday. 18, answer was B. And now we are going to the last two questions in the grammar section, 19 and 20. So, let's start. Choose the most natural answers to fill the blanks. Okay, first of all, again, we translate, of course, so 19... So we have Jigim, Wahe, Wahe, Jigim Wahe, Jigim Wahe, Jigim Wahe. What are you doing now? Oh, what are you doing now? Oh, what do you do now? Yeah, but I think it's more natural in English to say what are you doing now, even if the Korean is not progressive. I will keep it that way. And the answer is 나는 지금 친구와 친구와 영화를 보. So I'm now watching movie with a friend. I'm watching a movie with a friend right now. And we need to decide over the conjugation, I guess. Let's see. So, 보다 means to see or to watch. And let's see what we have here. Goita. So goita is progressive. So that would fit. That would definitely fit. So I'm going to put in A and next will be B and so on. So this one, the A blank filling would be I'm watching, so that's already progressive, so that's already the correct one. B would be Boagio. Boagio. What is Boagio? Agio. Agio. What is this? I have no idea what this is, to be honest. Boagio. I have no idea. Okay, we'll go to C. C would be we have was saw, so that's the past tense. So I was watching a movie with a friend right now. And D is Gmote. 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 Pojimote. I think this is like I couldn't watch a movie with my friend. Right? I couldn't? I think it's I couldn't. I couldn't watch a movie with my friend right now. Which makes no sense, obviously. Yeah, so I'm not sure what B is, but I think the... the most natural answer seems to be A. So I'm going with A, 19A. I want to check this part again. I think I have some chart here for that case. Oh wow. Yeah, okay, but it's enough. So not doing something because, okay, so yeah, I was remembering right. It's actually not doing something. It's not doing something poorly. It is not doing something at all because something is preventing. Okay, I was remembering that right, so that's very good. So that's why I said I couldn't watch. So I'm not watching the movie because someone's preventing, so I couldn't watch. That was my translation for that. So I think that fits. But for B, I'm not sure what it means. Ah, hi Kaya, Anyang. Me too, A. Do you know what the B, what B is? So I completely forgot this G or jaw. Like I remember that there was some grammatical concept that involved a G, and I don't mean a G anta. To just to make a negativity or negative conjugation. I think there was a G somewhere else, but I can't remember. And I'm not quite sure if that's the one, but there was a G somewhere. To become, but in this context doesn't make sense. To become. So it only makes sense with adjectives? Wait, let me try to find this lesson here. This one, I think. Oh, look at this. Korean passive verbs, normal verbs. Ah, could it be this one? I think it's this one. I think it's this one. A or O, ji da. And then we conjugate ji da, for example, like here, jiaseoyo. If we go back to this, yeah, this should be it. So, yeah, it makes no sense. But to become, you're saying to become. I remember there was something like to become, but it's not this one. So, what is to become? I know to become is dueda, but I don't know in what section it was, to be honest. Maybe in this part? Oh. Ah, this, yeah, this one, right? That's what the one you mean. Yeah, okay, this is the one you mean. Okay, nice. So that's only for adjectives. If it's not an adjective, then it's the passive form of the verb. So I was watched by a movie. I was watched by a movie with my friend. Okay, so then A is the correct answer in this case. And we are continuing. Twenty. Okay, Do saw. Do so gua. Do so gua, is it? It's, I think it's library, right? Do so gua, library? I think it's library. Do go sa e so can mean from for locations or inside if you have action that is being done inside of a place. I got this now. Nugunga. Okay, Nugunga, okay. Anyone? Anybody? Isoyo. Okay, nice. Is anyone in the library? And the answer is Jigim. Opsoyo. Right now, probably the answer will be nobody. Is nobody is, yeah. There, maybe. I don't know. The most natural translation. It's not the literal one. But right now, nobody is here. Before even looking at the answers, it should be Amu. Amudo. Amudo. And we have Amudo in the answers. Very good. Very good. So I would say. So here, let's see. This one is nowhere. Right now, nowhere is there. Makes no sense. Nobody is there. Also fits with the negative conjugation of, or the negative like variant of this verb, I guess. So this this is a negative form, so this fits with the rule that for nobody, nowhere, this, these no verbs, you have to have a negative sentence, which is the case here. Amuna would be anyone. Oh wait, I put anyone in a question, which is wrong. This is someone. Someone, sorry. Someone. Is someone in the library? Right now, nobody's here. Okay, so this would mean anyone. Right now, anyone is not here. There is not anyone. But this one. But that's not correct, because this one requires a positive sentence and this one requires a negative. So this one is more correct, because this one is negative. And here we have, what is this one? Anything. Makes also no sense. So it's definitely B. Definitely that. Okay. Perfect. I think that's easily correct. Bash for Height, welcome. Libraries, those buildings people go for free Wi-Fi. Greetings. People still go to study, I guess. Yeah, I think in universities, for example, like libraries of universities especially, you have people studying there most of the time, I think. Okay, so I hope I'm correct here, but I think I am, and I have to say, it's not that hard. I think so far it's actually quite easy. We will go on to 21, which now it will become very hard, I think. I love reading books. I don't have to buy. Can't you just buy books, like used books on eBay or so? And then after you read them, you sell them again. So it's basically for free as well. You pay an amount and then you get that amount back after reading. Okay, so we have an audio sample here. We have an audio file. We have to listen to it. And then we have to answer the question. What did the man eat for dinner? So instead of just listening to it and then answering the question, I will attempt to write down everything that is being said. Okay. Korean layout. I will hide the chat for me again. So I'm just concentrating on the task, and we start now.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
오케이. Okay. What did you eat for breakfast? And then the answer, I think, was he didn't eat anything. But let me, I just focus on the first sentence.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
아무것도. Yeah, that's correct. What did you eat for breakfast? Oh, wow. yeah, I guess I write down the Korean and the English.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
Okay, so it was something like 오전으로 먹었어요. What did you eat for breakfast? And then the answer was, it was a Amu Cordo. I have to listen again.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
안 먹었어요. 안 먹었어요. 아이 didn't eat anything. 오케이. So this is what I understood from the first three times hearing it or so, or four times, and I will just hear it and try to read the same and try to see if it's correct.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
I think it's correct, actually. I think it's correct. So the answer is then obviously okay, final answer. I'm watching the chat now. Whiting. Whiting, yeah. Gionoro? What? Gionocoro? Even a dinner? But the rest? I think the rest. Okay, you have Amukoto, and I have Amukodo. Okay, let's listen to that part again.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
It's very hard to recognize if it's Amukoto or Amukodo, if there's the S or not in the end. And I think also both are fine, right? But you heard John Yok. And I heard, oh, John. So let's listen to that part again.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
There's some O in the beginning, I feel.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어? 저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요? 저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
와.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요? 저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요? 저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
아무것도 안 먹었어요.
I can't. I definitely think there's an O in the beginning, in front of the jaw. So you hear the jaw, and I also have a jaw. John, I have John, and you have jaw. No, you have jaw. I have John. But before that, there's definitely an O sound, right? What is that then? Okay, so it's. Okay, I see. So that's not really a real part of the sentence, you say? Okay, that's hard.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요? 저녁으로 뭐 먹, 저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
Also, this "으로" "뭐" is so fast. I can just guess it. I cannot. Doesn't matter how. Even if I think it's correct, and I hear it again and again, I cannot recognize every sound there. It's just a guess because it kinda sounds like that, like "으로 뭐." It's crazy. Sentence starters, okay.
저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요? 저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요? 저녁으로 뭐 먹었어요?
Ja, there is something. Yeah, it kind of sounds like there's one more syllable than I have. So I guess you're correct. But I cannot hear. It's too fast. Like there are three syllables or four even, super fast, and I cannot. I have to like slow. Ah, okay. I can slow the speed actually. Yeah, okay, you're correct. Oh, but man, that part is really fast. Those syllables are really fast. Yeah, but you're correct. Okay, well, close one. But the rest I could understand pretty quickly, at least. Yeah, I will keep my answer like this. I know it's wrong, but I want to see how much I have wrong from my own attempt in the first try. I want to have the final result in the end, but I know it's wrong. It's definitely well, okay, well, the answer is correct. Well, I guess yeah, I guess the answer was correct anyways. I heard the important part for the answer, but I didn't hear everything correct. So yeah, I don't know how you will judge that. I don't know. Anyways, we go to the next one. When will the man go home? Okay, let's see.
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
집에 언제 가요?
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
오케이.
집에 언제 가요?
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
오케이. 집에. So when will you are home? And then he said something like han, so like something like 1 o'clock or so. Or we'll see. 1 hour from now probably is the answer, but I want to understand every part of the sentence first.
집에 언제 가요?
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
언제? 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 오케이. 언제야? Yeah, why not? Of course. Yeah, it's good. 가요? Something like this.
집에 언제 가요?
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
한 시간. Okay. 한 시간. God damn it. She gun. 한 시간.
집에 언제 가요?
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
거예요.
집에 언제 가요?
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
집에 언제 가요?
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
갈 거예요? What?
집에 언제 가요?
한 시간 후에 갈 거예요.
와우. 후에? I think I hear 후에, but then there's something like 가 아, 갈 거예요. 아, 오케이. 갈 거예요. 아, mistype. 갈 거예요.
집에 언제 가요?
1시간 후에 갈 거예요.
Ah, yeah, okay, now it's totally obvious. Okay, so I think that's correct. There needs to be a question mark in the question, of course. He is already home. 1 시간 after 1 hour, in 1 hour. 1 hour from now. Okay, so B is the answer. Okay. You have Shibe Onje Kayo Han Shigan Hue Kalkoyo. Ah, this Kalkoyo. I needed way too long to write that down. That's Goyeyo. For some reason, the go of Goyeyo, I thought it's go. And then I thought about grammatical principles that have the go, like go ship da or go eat da, but it all didn't make sense. But then I finally realized it's go, it's just future conjugation, that's it.
집에 언제 가요?
1시간 후에 갈 거예요.
갈 거예요, yeah. Now that I actually realized and I see it written out, I can hear it very easy, very obvious, but I struggled for a little bit. But in the end, I think it's correct and the answer is also correct. Okay, nice. Next one. So far, not as hard as I thought, this listening thing. The final boss. It got weaker. It got weaker. The final boss got weaker. Okay. Who is the person they are talking about? Okay.
그 사람은 누구예요?
그 사람은 저희 한국어 선생님이에요.
The teacher. Okay.
그 사람은 누구예요?
그 사람은 저희 한국어 선생님이에요.
Okay. Korean, 그 사람 누구예요? I'm not quite sure, but Yeo? Yeo?
그 사람은 누구예요?
그 사람은 저희 한국어 선생님이에요.
Wait, there was something like Saramun. Moon? What is Moon?
그 사람은 누구예요?
그 사람은 저희 한국어
Wait, what
선생님이에요.
did I even write there? 사람. 사람은. 아, 사람은. Wow. Okay.
그 사람은 누구예요?
그 사람은 저희 한국어 선생님이에요.
아, the Korean teacher. Okay. 아, I cannot write. 한국어 선생님 이에요. Okay, one more time.
그 사람은 누구예요?
그 사람은 저희 한국어 선생님이에요.
Oh, there's some jaw in there before 한국어.
그 사람은 누구예요?
그 사람은 저희 한국어 선생님이에요.
아, okay. My Korean teacher. 저의.
그 사람은 누구예요?
그 사람은 저희 한국어 선생님이에요.
Yeah, okay, easy. Did I have the English translation even in the last? No, I don't even have it. We don't need the English translation. That's easy enough anyways. 23, my Korean teacher. A Korean teacher. It's my Korean teacher, but my Korean teacher also includes a Korean teacher, of course. So the answer should be Okay, watching the chat now. Kö Saramin Nuguyeyo. Kö Saramin Joy Hanugo Sonsen Nimieyo. Perfect. Okay, I don't think we have to talk about this. Was fine. That means 24. You spelled person wrong. Oh, really? Wait, what? Let me see. What did I do? Oh, yes, of course. Okay. Oh my God. Yeah, in the beginning, I even wrote what's like Sagim or so. Completely wrong. Salam. Yeah, that's just a mistype. Sometimes I mistype for no reason because I can't hit the correct keys. Happens way too often, to be honest. But yeah. 24. Okay. Thanks, Kaya. Okay, then 24. I'm now hiding the chat again, and now we will listen to this one.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
What? Okay.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
Oh, that's a long one. Oh man. Oh man. I need a lot of listenings to this.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
Okay. Is it O'Neill or no? It's O'Neill, right? O'Neill. Der Gyo. Tanja. Tanja Jo. Makes no sense. Or does it? Did you go to university today? Oh, okay. Could be.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서
No, no,
졸업하고
no.
바로 일했어요.
That first question is still wrong.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
Okay, now it's correct, I think. Okay, now I focus on the answer.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
아, it's too much.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
아니에요?
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
와우.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
He's really saying 아니에요, right? So, Jigim de Haxeng. He's not a student anymore or so?
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
아니에요. Yeah, of course 아니에요. I just said it myself and then I write 이에요. 아니에요. How do you write this? 안 아니 아니에요, like this, right? I think like this, 아니에요. So, did you go to university? I'm not a student right now. What? This feels weird, but I have to understand the rest.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
어, man.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
거도. 거도? I hear 거도. 거도? 거. I'm very lost.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
Okay, wow. 학교에서. It's really frustrating that I only can understand like one word after one word and then I have to try again. I only have to focus on one word at a time. I cannot understand the full sentence, damn it.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요. I'm
어느
not
대학교를
concentrating.
다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
바로?
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
했어요. I may have to focus on the verb first.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
어, this is not going well.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
바로, what is 바로? 바로? 아, 바로, 야, 바로, Usually? No, immediately, right? 바로? Oh, man.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
오케이. I'm lost.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
조라, I hear like 조라. But yeah, it's clearly wrong, but this is what I hear. 조라, 바로.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
I need to.
어느 대학
학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요. 학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요. 학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요. 학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
졸업하고 졸업 졸업하고 I guess I just forgot about the specific word. It's the one I wrote there is definitely not correct, but I feel like I sh it's a verb that a word that I probably should know. Yeah, but I don't know.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일해요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
Okay, what could it mean? So, did you go to university today? I'm not a student right now. And then he's probably so saying something like, yeah, I'm working at the university in a specific way. I'm usually working in. Is it usually? I think it's usually, Pado. I'm usually working in the school. Oh wow! Wait. Now I see. Took a look at the. Just take a look at this. At the answers, and I now realize it's probably some name. Somewhere is a name that I can't know. It's not a verb that I learned. It's not an English word. It's just a name. Okay, so that changes things a bit. So let me re-listen.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
어느 대학교를 다녀요?
지금 대학생이 아니에요. 고등학교에서 졸업하고 바로 일했어요.
어느 대학
고등학교에서 졸업 고등학교에서 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 고등학교에서
I hear Kodok. It's not Konkuk. Koduk. No, it's. Well, so in the end, the answer is C, but it really frustrates me, anyways. Even if the answer. Maybe I get the answer correct, but that's not what I want. I want to understand the full conversation, but I don't. Okay, I'm reading the chat now. Okay, Kaya, what do you have? Wait, what? Wait, I have to read Kaya's first. Und der Kyoto Tanyoyo. Okay, so the question was correct. Jigim der Xeng I Anio. Oh, I forgot the E after Haxeng. Okay, yeah. Haxeng. Okay, so the question and the first sentence were more or less correct. No, which not today. Wait, what? Ah, oh nö. Ah, okay. Wow. Yeah, I even fail at reading. Yeah, which university are you going to? I'm not a student right now. And then what did you s Okay, so now the last sentence. Oh, it's very small here. Kordung. Ah, coding school. Coding school. Coding Hakyo. It's high school. Joropago. Jorop. Yeah, see, I forgot what Jorop is. Joropada. Joropada. I don't know what it is. 졸업하고 바로 일했어요. Okay, so there's one thing in the middle. That's what I didn't get. So the what I wrote Jora Pago, and you have Jodo Pago. I don't know what it is. Jodo Pago. Jodo. I don't know. I have to check it out on Papago. Okay. Shut up. To be envious. Chorop. Ah, Chorop. Be envious. Chorop. Wait, isn't this graduate? No, this is graduating. Joropa, does it? And now I remember it's graduating. It's not envious. Okay, now that I know what it is, it should be graduating. I now remember Joe Rob. Joe and Rob graduated. Joe and Rob. Joropada. Jo ah, yeah, okay, I know it. I know it now. Jo Jorop. Yeah, there we go. That's it. That's it. Joropada. Okay. That was a hard one. And I failed horribly. But I couldn't remember that word. So, Joropago. But I still don't get it, to be honest. Okay, let me fix the coding school as well. Coding Acquire. Okay, so it is. What is the goal? What is the goal? By the way, I see Elo MC Tang or Elo M MC Stang. thanks for tuning in. I will read all of your stuff after figuring this out. I want to stay in this sentence right now. Okay, I will answer everything. Jodo Pago. What is this go? What is this go? Jodo Pago. Go ita, go shippoyo. Those are the two that I know with go, but they both don't apply here. Jodo Pago. I graduated from high school immediately. After I. Choropago? No. Okay, so the sentence is after I graduated from high school, I immediately started working. Okay, so that's the translation. I got this, but I do still don't get the Choropago. After graduating, I immediately started working. I immediately was working. And for verbs. Oh yes, I graduated high school and immediately worked. I always forget about the go meaning and. To have basically two sentences connected. I always forget about this. I always think about Goshipta or Goita, which both doesn't make sense here. Okay, thanks, Gaia. So, C is correct. I got the correct answer, but well, we cannot count that. Oh well, okay, now I will read all the other stuff. First, I am Zeus. I am Zeus, if you're still here. I hope you haven't left yet because I ignored you. Hey, May. Hi, Ray, I hope. You had a program at one time to search replays by name and it shows all openings, blah, blah, blah. Do you know what it called? I forgot and can't find it. You know what? I developed that software. That's my own software. And you can find it below the stream. It's called SCR chart and the homepage is linked below my stream. So there you can find it. SCRchart.com. Just look below my stream, in my profile, in my description. You will find the link. Okay. By the way, if you have any questions, there's also an invite link for my Discord server for that software. Just for that software specifically, I have a Discord server. So you can just message me on Discord. My Discord contact details are also below the stream. Everything is below the stream in my profile. So just message me on Discord or join that Discord server of the software, and then I can help you get it running if you fail. Because it got a little bit harder than initially, so it's maybe a bit difficult. So if you have questions, just contact me. Okay, so now Elo MC Stang. Dude, how do you learn Korean? You got a private tutor. He learns from asterisks, asterisks, asterisks. Yeah, links are not allowed. If you write it down like with the IDEO, I don't know what ideograms is. I guess the letter, the Korean script. Probably it will show you something. Okay, so I will answer your first questions. I'm using the website called howtostudy.com. One second. Okay, it's in the chat now. And that website is this one. So there are two major websites where you can learn Korean. Those two are the best by far. It is this one, howtostudykorean.com, and it is also talktomeinkorean.com. That's another very good website to learn Korean. So if you want to learn Korean, just take one of those and you have everything you need there. So I'm just going to very quickly summarize how I learn here. There are different lessons. If you go to a random lesson here, let's just go to a random lesson. So you always have a vocabulary list in the beginning, okay? Vocabulary list. Vocabulary list in the beginning of each lesson. So you have around 40 words or so. And then after the vocabulary list, you have grammatical explanations. So you have vocabulary and grammar knowledge in each lesson. So that's why I like it. And for the vocabulary, there's also a word list basically on another website, which can be very well used for learning vocabulary specifically, only for vocabulary, which I also do. And that is this Memrise. Memrise is a website where you can learn vocabulary. It gives you automatically if you fail to remember some words, it will repeat them more often. And if you got a word like 5 times correct in a row, it will increase the time until it gives it to you to review again. So it's called a spaced repetition, I think. But this is a good website for vocabulary learning. And as you can see, I'm also using those vocabulary lists from each lesson from howtostudykorean.com. Yes, that's correct. if you go to memorize and you want to start learning vocabulary, just vocabulary or so, don't start with this Korean one. That's what I did initially, and it's not really good. Just go to howtostudykorean.com or talktomeinkorean.com, and you will find memorize word lists using with these words from those websites. That's better. Don't take this Korean one course. Yeah, and that's basically it. So that's how I learn. I always do these lessons here. They always have vocabulary. I have over 1K vocabulary learned by just doing those first 25 lessons. So I did tw 25 lessons, and that's over 1K vocabulary just from this website. Because every lesson, as I said, has around 40 words. And now, this is a special time. I just finished the first 25 lessons, which is unit 1 on this website, and I'm do now doing the big unit 1 test. So this is a very like special moment in this whole project that is going for 246 days already. So I'm just testing my skills from the last 246 days with this unit 1 test right now. That's it. That's how I learn, and that's my current status. Okay. So you can talk. Well, I can translate you stuff. I can translate English to Korean, Korean to English when you have it written out. It's easier for me. But talking. So the thing that I do here, not right now, I'm in the listening part of this test now. That's very hard for me still. Like, actually, listening to a fast speaking Korean, recognizing the correct Korean words is very difficult. If I know the Korean words, then I can translate to English almost no problem. But actually recognizing what he's saying in Korean, that's very hard for me. So that he needs a bit more time. I just have to listen to Koreans talking more. To just get used to it basically and recognize all the common words and syllables and so on. But yeah, that's it. Okay. Don't you watch any Korean streams of StarCraft? I'm not a big stream watcher, to be honest. I'm usually preferring to watch VODs of tournaments or so. And I'm doing that. For example, ASTL is currently running and it doesn't have English commentary, so I'm watching those in Korean. And yes, I understand a few things here and there, but they speak so fast. I'm really not at the level yet that I can fully understand those. It's just too fast. If I have a Korean who is saying every syllable like very slowly, for example, if I talk English like this, then I can understand everything. So with that speed, it's fine. You know, I can recognize all the Korean words, then I can translate them. It's all fine. But people are not talking like this. They are talking faster, and then it's too hard for me. I have to repeat the audio. For example, here I have these audio files. I have to repeat them every, like, a few times until I recognize all the syllables. So, yeah, it takes some time. Learning a language is hard, takes time, but I'm going strong. So, we are at the very last question now. Yeah, I feel that pain too, because I was learning Mandarin. Oh, Mandarin. I learned Mandarin for 1.5 years, but only like 4 hours each week or so in university, and I didn't really like it and I didn't continue. It was epic hard in listening. Yeah, listening is by far the hardest. Okay, so let's go. 25. This one gets removed, and now 25. Okay. I'm hiding the chat again, so I don't get don't get spoiled with the correct answer. 25, let's go.
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
검언네?
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
Ah, I don't understand the first part. Cargo, shipboyo. So, something want to go. Where do you want to go? Maybe, do you want to go somewhere? Something like that.
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
코모네, 코모네, 코모네. 콩원에? Kongwon, yeah, that should be it. Kongwon Park. Kongwon-e cargo shipboyo. Do you want to go to the park? Is it Kongwon? Or is it Kungwon? I'm not quite sure. Kungwon or Kongwon? Kungwon. I think it's like this. Do you want to go to the park? And now the answer.
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
Too fast,
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
가기 전에 아 오케이 okay. I got it. 오케이 okay. So 공원에 가기 전에 So before I go to the park,
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
Oh, that's hard. It's museum. Pang. 박물관 가고 싶어요. Man, I miss writing the whole time. 싶어요. 싶어요. 가고 싶어요. 응?
공원에 가고 싶어요?
공원에 가기 전에 박물관에 가고 싶어요.
Okay, that's it. Okay, so do you want to go to the park? Before we go to the park, I want to go to the museum. That's it. So, answer is D. Okay, now I'm revealing the chat again. Oh, we have Looney in the chat. Copio. Hi, Copio. but I still can't speak well. Okay, yes, museum. I think museum. Looney, so Looney is Copio, by the way. He's a long, very long time friend. Met him 2005 or 6, maybe? Think 5, 2005. Looney, why did you say museum? Was it after I said that it's museum? Or did you somehow recognize it from From Chinese even? There's no Polish flag in the bottom of the stream. Ja, Kaya ist in London. Ja, yeah, I have these flags below my stream, right? I added that years ago. I didn't even. I totally forgot about these flags. Okay. No, it's when you distinguish park or museum. I guess it's museum because of too many words. Ah, okay. Because the sentence was so long, you guessed that it was already also the long sentence in the answer. Okay. Yeah, that's it. That was a test. 25 questions. They're all done. And we will now. Yeah, it's already 18 minutes after the time, and I really have to stop very soon. So we'll go over the answers very quickly and then. Oh, we have audio transcripts. We have audio transcripts. Okay, give me 1 second, and then we'll go through these things. Or I have to leave. I'm checking. 1 second. Okay, yeah, I really have to leave very soon. The audio transcripts, I don't think we need to go through them. I think I will check them, but I don't think we have to do it here on stream. I just want to check the answers very quickly. So I'm going to copy everything I have in my notepad where I have all the answers. I'm going to copy this here. It will completely flood the stream, I know. But I think we can go through it like this. So I always put the answer behind the number directly. So 1C. Okay, 1C is correct. 2A is correct. 3 and 4BB is correct. 5A is correct. 6C is correct. 7D is correct. 8A is correct. Okay, so far so good. Eight A. Okay, we continue. Nine. Nine A and 10A, both correct. 11D correct. 12C, I wrote C, but it is B. Okay, 12 incorrect. I knew that. I mean, I already knew which answers I'm incorrect in because, or that I'm incorrect in some answers because I always talk to Kaya and another viewer who is often on the stream flow. I already discussed with them my answers, and then of course I know that some are wrong, but that's fine. So I remember definitely I had one wrong in the first 10 as well, but I guess I corrected it. So. With 12, 12C is wrong. So with 12, I have two wrong so far. Two wrong. 13C, 14. 14 is also incorrect. So 14 is B and I have C. So that's three incorrect. 15. 15A. 16C. 17D. 18B. 19. Nineteen A is correct. Okay, yeah, is correct. And 20B, 20, 1B, 22B, 23A, 24C, 25D. Okay, but one of those I definitely. Well, I have the answer correct, but I didn't understand the sentence correctly. So, yeah, I guess I have three wrong, but one. I'm not sure if you can count that. Probably not. So, like three or four wrong. I think it's good. I think it's fine. And no, there's no certificate or so. But I think it's good. I will go through the audio transcripts and see if there are any other mistakes, maybe, that Kaya maybe also didn't catch, but I don't think so. But I will read through that on off stream. And yeah, with that, the stream is over now. I have to leave. One last thing. First, read the chat. Chaleso, so well done. Thank you. Jagare. Reishiga Charang. I'm proud of you, Ray. Thank you. Okay. So after this test, I want to include a lot of other content on the stream. So I will not just go through lesson, through lesson, through lesson every time. We will have a lot of other contents, web comics, YouTube videos, specific other tests like this. Other websites where we can learn on. So I have a lot of different, I have a big list of different topics which are coming in the next weeks or months on the stream. So to have it a bit more flexible, a bit more fun for everyone. And we will talk about all of those things, all of those future topics, and we decide together what we will choose for the next weeks on Monday. Okay, on Monday, I will have a big list prepared with all the things, and we go through them very quickly and see what is the best suited for the stream. Okay? So, see you on Monday, I hope. Tomorrow is no stream, as always on Sunday. So, see you on Monday. Thanks for watching again. Thanks for always contributing here to the stream and doing the stuff with me, Kaya especially. Thanks for always correcting and helping me. And yeah, that's it. I will not associate this one with StarCraft so far. I definitely have some viewers who are not coming from StarCraft, and I don't want to annoy them with StarCraft content. So I will do StarCraft content on my StarCraft stream, or Korean content on my StarCraft stream, but not the other way around. Okay. I will, for example, translate Korean VODs or interviews in my StarCraft stream. I will translate them to English if I can. So that would be nice for the StarCraft fans, but this stream I want to keep mostly StarCraft free. So thanks for watching. See you on Monday. Bye bye. Annyeong.